हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर वैशाली देशमुख, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर श्री शिवाजी साइंस कॉलेज अमरावती. टुडे वी विल बी हैविंग द लेक्चर 7 ऑफ मॉड्यूल 1. इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अ वेरी पॉपुलर मेथड ऑफ थिन फिल्म डिपोजिशन एंड दैट इज स्प्रे पायरोलिसिस. आउटलाइन ऑफ द लेक्चर इज टाइप्स ऑफ थिन फिल्म डिपोजिशन टेक्निक. What is spray pyrolysis technique? Advantages of this technique. Spray pyrolysis equipment. Formation of thin film by using spray pyrolysis. Automation techniques. What are deposition parameters? How deposition of zinc oxide thin film is carried out by using spray pyrolysis technique. And finally, the application and the conclusion. So let us start with the types of thin film deposition technique. During the last several decades, coating technology have garnered considerable attention, mainly due to their functional advantages over the bulk materials, processing flexibility, and also the cost considerations. There are various techniques by which one can deposit thin films. The thin film deposition techniques can be broadly classified as physical methods and the chemical methods. The chemical methods can be split according to a gas phase depositions or a liquid phase depositions, where the chemical vapor deposition and atomic layer epitaxy are the gas processes. The choice of a particular method depends on several factors like material to be deposited, then nature of the substrate, required film thickness, then structure of the film, and also the application of the film. So among all these techniques, the solution spraying on hot substrate, that is spray pyrolysis method, is most popular nowadays, because a large number of conducting and semiconducting materials can be prepared by using this technique. So let us understand what is a spray pyrolysis. Spray pyrolysis is a process in which a nanostructure is obtained when a solution containing a spray cursor is sprayed or injected using a nanoporous nebulizer onto the hot substrate in the furnace, leading to the decomposition of the precursor to form the final desired material on the substrate. Or typically, it can be defined as spray pyrolysis is the aerosol process that atomizes a solution and heats the droplets to produce the solid particles. So here are the two terms, that is atomization and the aerosol. Atomization is the production of droplets and their dispersion into the gas. An aerosol is defined as the precursor, that is defined as the suspension of solid or the liquid particles in the gas. So from the words that is spray and pyrolysis, you can understand that something will come out as an aerosol and will be then heated to produce solid particles. So you have the atomizer which creates the droplets or fall on some substrate which is heated and gets those solvents, evaporates, and you will get the solid particles. So this is very simple method for making the nanoparticle, also called as the conventional spray pyrolysis method, by which you can deposit the thin films. So next to this, the advantages of this technique. So it is very simple and low cost film deposition techniques. It offers an extremely easy way to dope films with virtually any element in any proportion by merely adding it in the form of the spray the solution. It is applicable to large area. Unlike closed vapor deposition methods, spray pyrolysis does not require high quality targets or the substrates nor does it require vacuum at any stage, which is a great advantage if the technique is to be scale up for the industrial applications. Then depositions leads to relatively uniform and high quality film coatings. The deposition rate and the thickness of the film can be easily controlled over a wide range by changing the spray parameters only. No high temperatures are required during this processing of spray pyrolysis. So operating, it can be operate at a moderate temperature, that is from 100 to 500 degrees centigrade. So spray pyrolysis can produce the film on so the less robust material. Films deposited by spray pyrolysis are reproducible, giving it potential for the mass production. You do not need a very complex experimental setup for this technique. Then the precursors, that is the starting material used for the thin film depositions, are not very expensive. So beside the large number of advantages, these techniques had a few disadvantages. The technique was well suited for the synthesis of micro or even nanosize particles. However, an efficient separation technique was required for the production of these fine powders in order to avoid the loss of products and environmental pollution. So these processes often required high evaporation rates and usually took place within the short residence time. So this is all about the advantages of the spray pyrolysis technique. So here is the spray pyrolysis equipment. It consists of the different parts, that is spray nozzle is there, rotor for spray nozzle with speed controller is there, liquid level monitor is there, hot plate is with temperature controlling arrangement, then gas regulator wall, airtight metallic chamber and substrate are the parts, major parts of, main parts of this equipment. So spray nozzle is made up of glass and consists of inner solution tube, which is surrounded by gas tube through which carrier gas flows. With the application of the pressure to the carrier gas, a vacuum is created at the tip of the nozzle and the solution is automatically sucked and the spray starts. Then another part of the, that is a spray nozzle, is rotating on the to cover the all film area. So rotor is required for the spray nozzle, for the movement of the spray nozzle. And generally you know that the car wiper is moving from left to right, and simple that the car wiper, electric car wiper can be used to rotate the spray nozzle with the specification, that is 12 volt to 2 ampere, and that can be rotated along with the speed controller is there. Then liquid level monitor is there. This spray rate at a fixed pressure depends on the height of the solution we have filled. Then that measure with the reference to the tip of the nozzle, and the arrangement for the change in height of the solution forms liquid level monitor. Hot plate is there, the iron disc with generally diameter 16 cm and thickness 0.7 cm was supported on the electric heater. Maximum temperature up to 600 degree centigrade can be obtained with this arrangement, and chromel aluminum thermocouple was used to measure the temperature of the substrate and is fixed at the center of the iron disc. The temperature of the hot plate was monitored with temperature controller. Then there is a gas regulator wall. which is used to control the pressure of the gas. A coming gas tube of length 25 cm and a diameter of 1.5 cm were converted into a gas flow meter. Then airtight metallic chamber is there. Since number of toxic gases is evolved during the spray, it is necessary to fix the spraying unit in an airtight metallic chamber. An outlet of the chamber was fitted to exhaust to remove the gases which is evolved during the spray deposition. And above the hot plate there is a substrate, generally made up of quartz of silica material. It is chosen as the substrate and it is act as a plate. So it is called the quartz plate. Substrate is a passive component in the device and is required to be mechanically stable. So before starting or before using or depositing the film by using spray pyrolysis, you must be well known about the you must know the function of an each and every part of this equipment. So next is the procedure for the formation of thin films by using the spray pyrolysis technique. It is a solution based process. You must first make a solution of whatever material you want to deposit. So you must understood that there is a two ways, that is you can directly form the metal oxide by using the chemical methods, and then directly form nanoparticles can be dissolved in a soluble whatever the material that is soluble, that nanoparticles then you can use and make a solvent, and then you can spray it or deposit it on the substrate and can make the film. The other way is that you can directly form the metal oxide by using this technique, by using the decomposition technique. So you have to take a salt of that in aqueous medium. Typically you can make metal or the metal oxides powder. In the spray pyrolysis, precursor solution is atomized through a nozzle. The nozzle converts the solution into small droplets known as the aerosol. These aerosols are allowed to incident onto the preheated substrate. The pyrolysis, that is pyrolytic decomposition of the aerosols, depends on substrate temperature. Temperature plays a very important role in the formation of the thin films. The formation of thin film with desired properties are possible only at optimum substrate temperature. So the following are the various steps involved during the pyrolysis of the aerosol. That is, in the first step, an aqueous precursor solution is converted directly into the aerosols, or you can say droplets, by using spray nozzles. Then solvent evaporation takes place in second step. In the third step, evaporation of the solvent leads to precipitate formation as the droplets approaches the substrate, and then the pyrolysis of the precipitate occurs in succession before the precipitate reaches the substrate. Then in step 5, when the precipitate reaches the substrate, then nucleation and the growth of the metal oxide thin films on the substrate surface takes place. So finally, the growth of the nuclei leads to the formation of continuous thin layer of metal oxide. So these steps are involved in the formation of the thin films by using the spray pyrolysis technique. So the actual mechanism involved in the actual mechanism that is involved in the spray pyrolysis process and growth of the thin films are the atomization of the precursor solution, then the aerosol transport of the droplet, and then the droplets evaporation, then spreading on the substrate, then drying and decomposition of the precursor salt to initiate film growth. So these are the main three steps that are involved in the pyrolysis mechanism, that is technique. So the automation procedure is the first step in the spray pyrolysis deposition system. The idea is to generate droplets from the spray solution and send them with some initial velocity towards the substrate's surface. So there are the different techniques, and that is normally the spray pyrolysis uses, that is ultrasonic nebulized atomization, then improved spray pyrohydrolysis, corona spray pyrolysis is there, electrostatic spray pyrolysis, microprocessor based techniques are also there. So the atomizers differ in resulting droplet size, rate of atomization, and the initial velocity of the droplets. It has been shown that the size of the generated droplet is not related to any fluid property of the precursor solution, and depends solely on the fluid, that is, let us see, that is depend on the fluid charge density level, that is rho e, which is as shown in the equation 1, which is the radius of the droplet, can be calculated by using the equation number 1, where epsilon 0 is the permittivity, q is the elementary charge, and alpha by beta is a constant value, that is generally the 1 into 10 to the power minus 17 joule. And the mass of the droplets, that you can assume the spherical shapes, so depends on the its density, then it can be calculated by using the equation number 2, if we assume the shape of the droplets is spherical. So where r is the droplets radius and rho q is the droplets density, the final that is the initial living velocity of the droplet is an important parameter, because it determines the rate at which the droplets reach the substrate surface, the heating rate of the droplet, and the amount of the amount of time the droplet remains in the spray pyrolysis environment. So these are the very important parameters. So the in ultrasonic nozzles, if we apply the use the ultrasonic nozzles, which apply a relatively small amount of energy and can produce the droplets with a radius that is down to approximately 2 micrometer, but at the cost of a low atomization rate. And due to the ease of production, many companies choose to use the pressure atomizer instead of the ultrasonic atomizer. So these are the different types of the atomizers which are using in the spray pyrolysis technique. Then another one is the aerosol transportation in second step. So in the form, aerosol droplets are transported. Now once in atomization the droplets are to be formed, then in aerosol transportation droplets are transported and eventually evaporated. When thick film are desired, it is important that during transport as many drops as possible fly into the substrate without the formation of particles before reaching the substrate surface. So in this process, the solvent present in the droplets will evaporate during the transportation from the atomizing nozzle to the substrate. And the final stage is, that is the decomposition of the precursor. So many processes can occur when the drop hits the surface of the substrate, such as evaporation of residual solvents, then scattering of the drops, and decomposition of the salt. So many models exist for the decomposition of the precursor salt, but most authors suggest that the process of chemical vapor deposition gives high quality films by spray pyrolysis. So when the temperature is increased, at lower temperature the drop spreads through the substrate and then decomposes it. But at higher temperature the solvent evaporates completely during flight, and a dried precipitate drop hits the substrate. So where the decomposition occurs, that is at even higher temperature the solvent also evaporates before the drop reaches the substrate. Then the precipitate solid melts, vaporizes without decomposition, and the vapor diffuses into the substrate to undergo a chemical vapor deposition technique. So if we increase the temperature furthermore, the precursor evaporates before reaching the substrate, and consequently that is we need, or that is we expect, and hence the if the precursor evaporates before reaching the substrate, then consequently the solid particles are formed after the chemical reactions which is in the vapor phase. So this is all about the final phase of this technique. Then different deposition parameters which plays a very important role in the deposition of the thin films. So the main deposition parameters of the spraying system, such as the substrate temperature, the spray duration, the spray deposition rate, the gas flow rate, the distance between the nozzle and the substrate, and the hot plate rotation speed. So on these parameters the deposition of the thin films is dependent. So the substrate temperature is a most important deposition parameter. The morphology of the thin film is highly dependent on the substrate temperature at the time of deposit in the spray pyrolysis. And another one is the spray rate, which is also another important parameter, which influences the property of films form. It has that properties like crystallinity, surface morphology, relatively or resistivity and thickness are affected by the changes in the spray rate. So this is also the another important parameter. Higher spray rate results in the rough film thickness. So the smaller spray rate requires higher deposition time, and obtaining films of the same thickness prepared to the higher spray rate. Another parameter is the precursor solution. So it plays a vital role in the formation of the thin films by using the various compounds. The true solutions, colloidal dispersions, emulsions and salts can be used as aerosol precursors. So aqueous solutions are usually used due to ease of handling, safety. It is also the low cost, and there will be the wide availability. Or you can use the water soluble metal salts as a precursor. The solute must have high solubility, which increases the yield of the process. Then the all this parameter is also important because it can influence the properties of the deposited films. The next parameter is another parameter is also there, that is the distance between the nozzle and the substrate. Okay, so nozzle generally having the spraying angle, therefore the nozzle substrate distance determines the area coated and deposition rate. So smaller the distance of the atomizer to the substrate, then higher the deposition rate and smaller the coated area. So at small distance products, cooling of the substrate occurs. So simultaneously more heat is required from the heating plate. Okay, because the nozzle is moving from left to right, so the temperature should be maintained. Because the droplet mass flow density increases with the increasing distance and the flow characteristics of the liquid jet leaving the inlet port have a strong influence on the radial distributions of the droplet diameter and the mass flux density in the spray. So these all these parameters plays a very important role in the deposition of the thin films. So let us understand how the zinc oxide films can be prepared by using the spray pyrolysis technique. Zinc oxide is a semiconductor with a wide band gap which is equal to 3.37 electron volt and large excitation binding energy. It has excellent chemical and thermal stability, low cost, richly abundant, environment friendly, non-toxic nature, strong oxidizing power, high photosensitivity and high resistance to radiation damage. ZMO is an attractive material for applications in electronics, photonics, acoustic and sensing. Thin films of ZMO may be manufactured by the spray pyrolysis technique. In general, the physical properties of thin films are determined by using the number of factors that is we have discussed, that is the substrate. So in this ZNO thin film deposition, we can use the soda lime glass. Note down, that is to select a particular substrate, one has to take into consideration of the lattice parameter of the substrate so that it matches to the lattice parameter of the grown film. Otherwise, structural mismatch may create mechanical fracture in the film. So it is also necessary to consider the melting point of the substrate material. It should be comparable with that of the film material. The nature of the substrate may be non-crystalline solids like glass, glass of vitreous silica, or crystalline such as cleavage plates of rock salts or the mica. So substrate plays an important role. This is another important parameter, that is the temperature of the substrate we already discussed. For this deposition of ZNO, you can choose the temperature range, or most of the researchers have studied the varying temperature range from the 200 to the 500 degree centigrade, because we don't know the where the decomposition will be takes place. So the temperature of the substrate during deposition of the film may affect the film properties. At low temperature, polycrystalline film with high densities of structural imperfections are formed on both the vitreous and the crystalline substrate. But at the high temperature oriented, that is single crystal film are formed on crystalline substrate. So you can study the effect of variations in variations of temperature on the phases of the films. By variation with temperature from 200 to 500 degree centigrade, one can investigate the effect of the substrate temperature on the film morphological, structural as well as the optical properties. Then the distance of the nozzle, that nozzle to the substrate, that can be 1, 2, 3 and 4 centimeter, you can adjust. Then the concentration of the precursor in water. To make a ZNO thin film, the liquid solvent use is the water. So here is the procedure. So all these parameters plays a very important role. So you must very first fix all this parameter, that is temperature, substrate to nozzle distance, as well as the while choosing the substrate, you must concentrate on the melting points as well as the Miller indices. And here is the procedure to form the ZnO thin film. So zinc oxide thin films are synthesized. For this, you can use the zinc chloride as a precursor solution in water. It is dissolved. So 0.1 mole solution, molar solution of zinc chloride anhydrous is prepared in 200 ml distilled water. Clean glass slides were then placed on a solid uniform thermal conductor surface to provide proper heating with uniformity to the films. A heater is used as a heat source to provide temperature of around 200 degree centigrade. So at 200 degree centigrade you can try. After spraying film on glass slides, then it can be again sintered at a furnace for 1 hour for the 500 degree centigrade. So you can use this method to form the ZnO thin film. So also you can use as a precursor, that is zinc acetate dehydrated, as an original elements. You can take 0.08 molar concentration, and that is zinc acetate dehydrated. It is diluted in the methanol. So you can also try this precursor for the deposition of ZnO thin film. Again, the researchers also study thermal decomposition of zinc nitrate. So zinc chloride, zinc acetate, zinc nitrate, you can use a zinc nitrate aqueous solution. You can use as a precursor solution. Then this zinc nitrate has been decomposed and we get the pure zinc oxide particles. Okay, so this is all about how the zinc ZnO thin film can be deposited by using the spray pyrolysis technique. The use of spray pyrolysis as a route for thermal synthesis of chemical material was used in many industries for a variety of applications such as fuel cells, foods, that is milk powder, cereals, coffee, tea, then pharmaceuticals, antibiotics, medical active ingredients, and consumer goods, that is paint, pigments, ceramic materials, catalyst support. So thin films are widely used in today's technology, and their applications are widespread in the future. Thin films of current interest owing to their potential use in the that is electronic component, that is light emitting diodes, laser diode. Beside this also the photoelectronic device, for example photovoltaic solar cells, photoconductive devices, then coatings technology, sensors, integrated components for the telecommunication. So these are now under active considerations of the experimental physicist. So in recent times, popular utilization of this thin film deposition techniques as a absorber of the solar cells in use. So these are the wide range of applications of the spray pyrolysis technique. So finally, the conclusion, that is spray pyrolysis is a versatile and effective technique to deposit metal oxide films. The quantity, quality and properties of the film depends largely on the process parameters. The most important parameter is the substrate surface temperature. The higher the substrate temperature, the rougher and more porous are the films. If the temperature are too low, the films are cracked. The deposition temperature also influences the crystallinity, texture, and other physical properties of the deposited films. The precursor solution is the other important spray parameter which affects the morphology and the properties of the deposited film. In addition, the film morphology and properties can be drastically changed by using various additives in the precursor solution. Here are the list of references. A great physicist, Albert Einstein, said, "Two things are infinite, the universe and human stupidity. And I am not sure about the universe." Thank you for your kind attention. If any question in mind, you can me find at nanosynthesis2020@gmail.com. Thank you.